Are you looking to smash your opponents at the next standard event, poison your foes in Pauper, or empty libraries in Eternal formats? No matter what way you prefer to vanquish the foul, you'll find the tools you need at channelfireball.com. We've got great prices on singles, boosters, sealed boxes, sleeves, and anything else you need to take home the win at your next PTQ or at your kitchen table. Don't get lost in a labyrinth of online shopping. Just try channelfireball.com.
All right, this is Matt Sperling of Channel Fireball. I'm going to be bringing you a live, not live, a recorded standard daily event with the deck red, well, mono-green devotion, splashing Xenagos, and a couple sideboard cards. This is kind of a fun version, I would describe it as. It's trying to play the following expensive stuff. 3 Ugin, 2 Hornet Queen. The typical 4 Wiswood Elemental. Got 1 Arbor Colossus in there as a stand-in for Shamanic Revolution. Got 4 Pelucranos. 1 Frontier Siege. The list I copied had 2, but I decided to go for 3 Voyaging Satyr instead. Kind of bring myself a little bit closer to reality and a little bit out of Christmas land. I've still got plenty of Christmas land fun stuff. I cut a Genesis Hydra for a 4th Pelucranos, figuring that I want to make my 4 mana a little bit better than my 6 and 8 mana because I've already got so much business. All right, welcome to round 1 of Constructed Standard Daily Event. I'll play first. I'm playing Mono Green Christmas Land Devotion. Pretty easy keep here. No accelerant, so not a great hand, but a 3 drop and 4 land. I mean, it's just not really a hand you can mulligan. I'll get to scry and try to find something that's cheap. Or play a Pelucranos I would keep, I guess. F8. Interesting card. Don't have a Nykthos for devotion, but it is something cheap to do. Don't know what my opponent's playing. I'm inclined to keep it. At least it's not a land, right? Something I can cast. Alright, playing against a Mardu deck. So, Mardu deck typically takes a token variety, takes the approach of Crackling Doom is not as popular as it used to be. Now people are playing more cards like Thoughtseize and Chain of the Rocks and stuff, so I haven't been playing too much Standard, but I've been talking to some of my teammates about Standard and the metagame, and, you know, trying to figure out the best deck to play. I don't know that this Green Devotion deck is the best deck to play, but hopefully I'm trying to learn something about Green Devotion and its place in the metagame by playing this particular slow version and seeing, okay, is it fast enough to compete, or does it need to be tweaked and brought back down into a more curve-conscious red-green devotion with Crater's Claws and other 4 drops, perhaps, like some people play one copy of the Team or Saberclaw, just a kind of a lower curve in general. Alright, so nice. I love when you just reveal the perfect turn 4 play with that courser. Hopefully the card underneath is a land. We'll really be off to the races. Opponent has not committed a here we talked about, there's the Chain of the Rocks we talked about. Now obviously, like, he's representing, oh, I've got another Chain of the Rocks, I'm willing to use my first one when I see your Pelucranos, but it's fine. We'll play his 1/1 removal eventually. He's not gonna have one. That'll be that. 1/1 removal. Okay, he's missing his land drop. We have an empty board. Xenagos. Let's go for it. If you could guarantee your opponent was gonna be missing their 3rd land drop, everyone should be playing 4 Xenagos now. You're not always in this fortunate situation. Obviously, it looks great on an empty board. One of the big questions about this deck is, can you play 4 Xenagos in this format? I'm doing it, but it doesn't mean, like, it's actually going to be reasonable. I'm just trying it out. I want to see how good Xenagos is. I'm playing 4 copies. I'm playing a maximum amount of expensive stuff to ramp into. Here, my choices are Pelucranos or making another token. I think Pelucranos is plenty good. I'm just going to play it. Make a token. I think if I send both tokens and he just, like, you know, has some another kind of Doomblade type of card chained or stance, then I'm gonna lose my Xenagos and my Pelucranos. So I'm just gonna send 1 Satyr in. Not concerned about racing his life total. I'm gonna win this game as it's going. Yeah, he gives. All right. Got a little peek at what he was up to. See how you want to sideboard. They usually sideboard out token stuff, and they move into kind of a Wrath End Hostilities type of strategy. I still find Nihilus Disciples sometimes helpful when you're on the draw. Reclamation Sage, I love it against Chain of the Rocks. This kind of stuff. If they have Phoenix, this is good. If they have tokens and or whatever, I mean, the cards are okay. Rabble Master. On the draw, like, he'll probably keep his Rabble Masters in, so try it. None of these other, I mean, one of these is decent. This will kill a flyer. So I don't mind those cards. Although this is kind of a little bit sketchy. Like, I guess I don't really want, like, both my Ugins in a post-sideboard game. He's playing Wraths, but, like, it's kind of hard to ramp. I want my Xenagoses, I think. In the Wrath, again, thinking about the context of the games, it's like he's going to have, I guess it's good against Stormbreath. Arbor Colossus or Hornet Queen? Arbor Colossus or Hornet Queen? He has Valorous Stance, which makes it bad. Chain of the Rocks makes it bad. I'd rather have a Hornet Queen, I think. Nihilus Disciple, I put it in there. I'm on the draw. Frontier Siege, let's not kid around. I got some cheap interaction. Maybe I can cut one void. You don't want to, like, overcommit into Wraths. Maybe I'll try going cheaper. Just beat him with, like, legit stuff and not have to worry about going big. Ugin's obviously good when they have Chain of the Rocks sitting around. I already got two Reclamation Saves to try to handle that. All right, so we're going to go way smaller and basically play, like, a nickel and dime approach. I'm not sure this is the right way to go. Maybe let's actually get into one more, like, fatty. Okay. All right, submit that. Still kind of tinkering as I go. I've never been a big believer in sideboard plans as opposed to just, like, figuring out on the fly. And also bringing into it, just learning a new deck, coming into it with a sideboard plan and using that as, like, a crutch. I mean, I don't like that. I like to get in there, get in the weeds, figure out which cards I think are good. Later on, I might check that against someone else's impression of it, but right now I'm kind of exploring Green Devotion in the new standard, and I'll just try cyber as I go.